Hi friends, I'm Crystal Bessie of the Louisiana Farm to School program. This month's Louisiana Harvest of the Month comes in all sorts of beautiful sizes and colors, and its name celebrates probably your favorite season. It's summer squash. There are so many interesting things to know about this amazing group of vegetables. Let's head out to the farm to find out more. By now you may be wondering, what is a summer squash? Well, one obvious feature is that summer squash are available or in season during the summer months. Summer squash are small, fast growing, and usually consumed when the fruit is immature. They have soft shells, meaning like their skin or their peel is easily eaten and soft. And that's the opposite of a squash like a pumpkin, which has a hard shell. It's actually in the skin that contains the majority of the nutrition. Both summer and winter squash are members of the cucurbit family, or gourd family, along with melons, pumpkins, cucumbers, and gourds. The name squash came from a Native American word called ascuta squash, which translates to mean eaten raw or uncooked. The earliest varieties of squash are thought to have originated in Mexico and Central America almost 9,000 years ago. Squash was important to the native diet of these peoples, along with corn or maize and beans. They had a companion growing method called the Three Sisters. In this growing method, the corn stalks offer climbing bean vines support as they grow and reach for sunlight. The beans, in turn, pump beneficial nitrogen back into the soil and fertilize the corn and the squash. And then the squash's broad, spiny leaves protect the bean plants from weeds and animals. Summer squash you commonly find in Louisiana are scallopini, patty pan, straight neck, crook neck, and the most popular, zucchini. I'm here with Lester Williams of Bachelor, Louisiana, and he's the owner of Williams Produce, and he's also the president of the Pointe-Coupee Minority Farmers Co-op. So thanks so much for having us today. We really appreciate it.
I'm glad to have y'all. Wouldn't have it no better.
Tell me a little bit more about how you got into farming.
I got into farming doing it for my mother after she had got to the point she couldn't grow stuff no more, and I decided I was gonna just grow it and give her fresh stuff. When she would get it, she would share with a friend the fresh peas, the fresh greens, and her friend started sharing with more people, and then everybody wanted the fresh stuff, so that got me going. And I got involved with stores and from there to larger scale of vegetables.
You not only sell to schools, but you also do some visits to the school as well and talk to some of the kids, I think.
Yeah, bringing fresh vegetables to the schools and helping kids eat more healthy is one of the best things any vegetable farmer can do.
So tell me a little bit about what types of squash do you grow here on your farm?
Yellow squash, zucchini squash, yellow scoop squash, white scoop squash, spaghetti squash. Oh, I can go on and on and on. You know, anything that looks like a squash, I'll grow it.
How often do you have to come out here and harvest your squash?
Once it starts putting on, you have to harvest like almost like okra, almost every 3 days, 3 to 4 days, because when you're harvesting by like this, you got something like that, and when the warmer it gets, the faster it put on. So you would be out here like every 3 days, you'll be picking squash. If you don't, it'll be oversized in about 5 days.
You want to pick it when it's still
young and tender.
That's right. Now let's head over to Judy and see what she's got cooking from the garden.
Today we're talking about squash, the family of vegetables called cucurbit. And because it has that funny name, that's why we call it squash, because it's easier to say. So right here, I have the fruit of the squash plant and the flower on the end. So they'll usually have a male flower and a female flower, is that right?
That's right.
Notice how little this squash is. You let it grow a little bit bigger than that before you harvest it. So this big squash that I have right here is called a zephyr squash. And this is a summer squash. It's a crook neck. And look how it has some green on the end and it's yellow. Well, the benefit of all this color that's on the squash is some of the nutrients that we find in it. So why should we eat more squash? Well, it's rich in vitamin C, very rich in vitamin A, dietary fiber, and one of my favorite reasons to tell people to eat more squash is because of all the potassium that's in it. So the first thing I'm going to do is take this great little knife that I have, and that it makes it great to use in the classroom because you won't get cut with it. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut off one end of the squash here, like that, the other end like this, and then I'm going to cut it in half. And the best way to do that is to put it on that flat end, like that, and then... So this is our squash that we're going to put into our casserole dish, like this, and I'm going to scoop those seeds out with the spoon so that there'll be a space to put the other vegetables. So we're going to scoop this out. I'm going to fill this little pocket with some ingredients that I have here. What I have here is some rice that I've already cooked, black beans, corn, and some salsa. In the frying pan, I'm going to fry this onion and garlic, and I'm going to put some seasonings like cumin and chili powder that goes so well with these beans and corn. Now we've got our squash ready to go. It's going to go into an oven that's been preheated to 350 degrees for about 20 minutes. And when it's done, you'll serve it with things like a little cilantro, some sour cream, whatever kinds of ingredients you enjoy on something like this.
Did you know that one-third of the world's food production depends on bees? In other words, every third spoonful of food depends on pollination. In particular, squash crops depend on bee pollination in order to produce fruit. Bees are needed to transport pollen from the male flower to the female flower on a squash plant in order for fruit to grow.
Alright, so we're out here in this beautiful green field. We're in some squash rows. Tell me about what you've got growing right here.
This is zucchini squash. This is an old aloo zucchini squash. And it's real healthy for you. It's real good for you. This zucchini squash will have stripes on it. Green to have it's green with yellow stripes on it.
I've got a green zucchini here with me, and these are kind of young plants, I believe.
Right.
And how long does it take to grow a zucchini about this size?
About 40 days, they should be about that size.
So tell me about the blossoms and how do you know what the male and the female flower are?
The male is just gonna make a flower. The female is gonna make a flower with a fruit on it.
We have a lot of blooms happening on this
right.
plant, I believe. I think I see, can you show me some female?
This is a female right here. See that fruit right there? And this a male right there. These are males because they don't have a fruit on the end of it. That's a male.
So it starts looking like the stem gets a little thicker.
Right.
And that's actually the fruit that's growing behind
that
a female flower.
Here.
Okay, so I think here we're at another yellow squash plant.
Right, yellow straight neck.
Yellow straight neck.
Here's the squash after the production of the squash, the yellow squash.
Oh, yeah, I see.
And
yeah, so the blossom is at the end, and the fruit.
Yep, when you see it, when you see that small fruit we looked at over there, that lets you know that's a female. See, here's another female.
Yeah, so now this one's turning yellow, so you can really see the fruit.
Right, then we got another one right over here. And then the rest of them is males. You can see them, the males.
Yeah, they're just a flower
just
on
flower,
a stem.
Right. What they'll do, continue to grow, continue to pull out fruit. You start getting a lot of females, like you got males, you start getting as many females.
Mr. Lester, thank you so much for welcoming us today and showing us all of your great summer squash you have growing. We really appreciate you having us out today.
Well, it was a pleasure to have y'all to come out, and I thank y'all for, you know, being here.
Well, thank you. We appreciate it. Thanks for today.
I thank all of y'all for coming.
The Louisiana Harvest of the Month program showcases a different Louisiana food each month in Louisiana communities. We hope you will join us in tasting Louisiana this month.